I'm using a watercolor pencil to trace around the edges, but you can use any type of pencil or pen that you would like to trace out the design. I'm being careful not to press too hard. You don't want to impress line into your watercolor paper. I'm putting pastel on the back of the tracing, and then I'll flip it back over, and then I'll be able to trace over it and put the design onto the watercolor paper. But you can also rub graphite on the back side of your tracing. You can use anything that won't harm your watercolor paper. Thank you. I'm using a 1/2 inch flat brush with slightly tinted water to fill in the first area that we're going to work on. This is a large painting, so we're going to work on small areas at a time, and we're going to do wet and wet mostly. So I'll be wetting each area with clear water or slightly tinted water just before I begin to paint. I use the tinted water so I can be sure to tell where I've put the design. I do that because we use pastel on the back of the tracing. I'm laying in lavender with a little bit of neutral tint mixed into it, a very thin mix. I'm putting it onto the wet mixture and creating soft edges on each side. This will create folds of the seashell. It's very warm in my studio, so I'm continually adding water to keep the paper damp because I want all soft edges. And then after I lay down the basic tint like I am right there, I will take clear water and put on the edges to be sure that it's soft and continues to create the folds in the seashell. I take a clean tissue and pull out the highlight there on the seashell. It's real easy to take a tissue and just gently lift color if you need to. Thank you. I'm adding a little bit of rose madder, or you could use permanent rose with a touch of ultramarine blue. Before I start painting this section, I'm using clear water. Just be sure that it stays nice and wet so we can continue to have these beautiful soft edges. Okay, now I'm beginning to pull the paint down. With clear water added to the mixture that we just put on there, we're going to pull the paint down so that we can get the contour of the shell. I'm letting each layer dry before I go back, before I add another layer to it. So right here I'm adding clear water to this new section before we lay down the pigment. And I'm using a mixture of ultramarine blue, a little bit of rose, and then a tiny bit of indigo. My palette is very compatible. The colors are very, very compatible with each other, so I can mix and match. And what I like to do is each time I go into my palette, I like to pick up just a little bit of a different color so that we have different tones marbleized throughout the painting, and this makes more interest. So from here on out, I'm just going to be mix and matching my colors, all of what you've seen in the description. I'm making sure that each section that I do is not next to a wet section. So I may have to skip a section. Be sure that you're not putting a new section next to a wet section, or it's all going to run together. Throughout the painting, I continue to use a spray bottle to keep everything moist, keep an even moisture across the painting, and that way you don't get the blooms, the little cauliflower effect. Now we're getting ready to paint some of the sand. We're using burnt umber, and we'll be mixing in a little bit of neutral tint and ultramarine blue, just all kinds of random colors. Then when I'm through putting it in there, I will be putting kosher salt on there and letting that dry. Dry it completely before you move on, and this is going to create a beautiful sandy beach texture. Turn your painting around every now and then so that you can be ergonomically correct, make it easier for you to do your brushwork. I turn my painting every different angle that you can imagine. Trying to decide what I want to do here. We're getting ready to put the clouds in there. So, okay, right here on this right-hand corner, I'm getting the paper super wet. I mean, it's not going to be running all over everywhere, but it has really, really dried out. So I'm going to be spending a little bit of time getting that wet, and then I'm going to take some Thalo Green and some Cobalt Blue, and we're going to start working on the ocean wave there that's behind that seashell. I'm using a soft brush to brush the salt off of the painting after it's totally dry. Using a large soft brush, we will wet this area where we're going to do the sky. Get it nice and wet. I like to soak it pretty good and then I watch it. When the super shiny part goes away and it's just a matte finish, that's when I begin to paint. If you get it really, really nice and shiny wet, then you know you're getting enough water in there to soak into those fibers. But wait until you get a nice matte before you start painting. I use Ultramarine Blue for the sky. My drawing table is at about a 25 degree slant, so I will be moving the painting around to make the water go in the directions that I want it to go. Adding a mix of lemon yellow and yellow ochre, a very light mix. A little bit of indigo blue and ultramarine blue with a little bit of burnt under to make the shadow. Adding a mix of ultramarine blue and thalo green, about a medium mixture. Adding clear water to the top of the waves. Going to make the crest of the waves. I'll be adding clear water, and then I'll be adding Dr. P.H. Martin's white ink. Adding a mix of light gray to add a little bit of shadow to the top of the wave before we put the ink on there. Dr. P.H. Martin's white ink. The area is pretty wet so that the white ink will run down and look like water spilling over the wave. Ultramarine blue to add depth to the wave. I am glazing that over. I'm adding clear water, getting ready to add the P.H. Martin's white ink. So if you've made it this far in the video, you're my hero. Thank you for watching, and please like and subscribe. I hope to put out